Hey there. I thought I would talk to you today about craft glitter. A lot of people call up and they say, "Hey, we want craft glitter that's really, 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 really small and really fine." And they're thinking like ultra fine. And you can't really make craft glitter ultra fine. And I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to explain it to you so that you can kind of get a technical understanding of it, so that it'll make sense to you. So I'm going to go ahead and jump right in here, okay? So, I'm going to show you some samples of uncut craft glitter film. So, this is what the film looks like before it's been cut. It's really, really thick. It's got a lot of snap to it. Craft glitter is a really tough glitter because it's thick, but it doesn't have the coating on it. Like this coating right here, if you were to go ahead and put, nail polish or polish remover, it wouldn't last. The color would go, and then eventually it would melt and so forth. So you definitely the coatings matter, but in craft glitter, when you're cutting small particle sizes, it isn't so much the coating that matters; it's the thickness. So what happens is when you've cut it into a big chunk, let's say a mammoth square or a colossal flake, you're basically seeing a whole lot of the top surface, that quarter inch by quarter inch, or the eighth inch by eighth inch, you're seeing a lot of that. And so you're getting a huge amount of sparkle from that surface area. When you cut it smaller and smaller, less surface area for the light to bounce off. And we've covered this in other lectures, but we haven't talked about one thing, and that is when you get super, super small, and we're talking like fine, what you see is as much of the surface as the edge. And remember, I told you that this is really thick, it's like 6 to 7 mil film. So when you're cutting this into a tiny, tiny flake, you're only seeing a tiny bit of this part, the shiny part, but what you're also seeing is a heck of a lot of the edge, which isn't shiny. So what you'll get is a combination of shine and dull. So the smaller you go, and the smaller you go, the smaller you go, you start running into edge problems, essentially, because it's such a thick film. So people are like, "Oh, I really like the fine. I really like the fine." Well, I like the fine too. It's really great for certain things, but less sparkle, less bounce off the front, more bounce off the side. So that's why I say, hey, if you need those really, really fine particles, like below 0.015, you got to jump over to the polyester. And the reason why is because polyester film is extremely thin. It's like 2 mil or even 1 mil. And on the really, really fine stuff, like the companies that cut it for, like eyeshadows and all this kind of stuff, it can even be a half mil. And I've even seen it as thin as a quarter mil, which is ridiculous. That would be like the really super fine powders. So this is just a quickie kind of explaining why in craft glitter, finer isn't necessarily better. Everyone's really hot on going fine, 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 and ultra fine. Yeah, that's great. If you need ultra fine or even fine, jumping over to polyester is a better idea. I've seen some fine glitters that we've cut in craft, and I look at it and go, "Oh, it's pretty," but I'm seeing an awful lot of edges, and I'm thinking, "Gosh, I hope that will work for people." Now, if you're careful and you spread it out nice and thin, and you really work to get that surface, you'll see less edges. But if you're just like throwing it into a pile, you're going to see a lot of edges. So this just kind of explains to you why you don't necessarily want to see an ultra fine craft glitter. One, it kind of turns into a powder because it's just not meant to go that fine, but two, edges. Okay? So keep that in mind. All right, bye-bye.